Welcome back to Proactive, and I'm talking to the chief executive of the full-service viral challenge study company, hVIVO now. It's Mo Khan. Mo, great to see you again, and some big news out this morning. You are going to be moving to some brand new facilities over in Canary Wharf.
Yeah, very exciting news indeed. It's a big moment for hVIVO. We have, as you know, we've seen significant growth in our company over the last 18 months, and the future outlook also looks very strong. So we have decided to move our company headquarters to the new life science hub at Canary Wharf. Canary Wharf has been a very ambitious group and talking life science companies to come into that region, and we're very pleased to be part of that. The move will include the consolidation of our quarantine beds, our laboratory, and corporate offices into a single facility. Our hugely successful screening facilities, both in Plumbers Row in East London and in Manchester, will remain at their current locations. But the rest of the company will be consolidating into one facility. And the timing for the move is actually ideal, considering the current leases we have in place. They're currently aligned. We, in fact, also have financial support from our customers, giving us funding for a substantial part of the cost with regards to the move and the fit out of the new facility. And also, we also have been able to get a really kind of good facility at a very good price. So all in all, the ideal time to move. I'm very excited by this move, and I'm sure our employees and our customers will also be equally pleased.
It all sounds very positive, Mo, but what do you think is going to be the real difference in practical terms between your current facility and your brand new one in Canary Wharf?
Well, it's huge differences, to be honest. Just to kind of list a few, just kind of top line items. So firstly, we will be adding more beds. So in fact, we will have 50 quarantine beds with an option to expand to a total beds of 17 quarantine beds. So that's a big change. Our laboratory space will be bigger and much more efficient. In fact, our current lab space isn't really efficient, and also it's kind of reached its maximum potential. And as we continue to increase the number of challenge trials we're running, as well as a more standalone laboratory business, we needed a bigger laboratory space. So this will have that and be able to run more standalone lab work. We will also be able to do a lot more studies concurrently. At the moment, we are limited by the buildings we have with regards to how many trials we can run concurrently. In the new facilities, well, at least theoretically, we can actually run 50 different challenge trials at the same time, because each bed is a standalone quarantine zone in itself. So all in all, the amount of potential we will have with regards to generating more revenue will increase. But on top of that, of course, having the facility consolidated onto two floors into a single building will, you know, improve operational delivery, enhance efficiencies, and I'm sure it will have a very positive impact on the company culture too.
Great stuff then. So give us a bit more information, Mo, about the timeline for this, and tell us what's going to be happening with your old facilities.
Yeah, so the work on the new facility has just started. We expect to have the first phase of the new fit out and move completed in Q1. So we will have a limited number of quarantine beds available in Q1 of 2024. And we expect to complete the full move in Q2 of next year. And during this period, we will have both the Whitechapel hotel facility as well as the Q&B facility fully operational. So there will be a time where we will have overlap of the new facilities. And we need this anyway, because we need to make sure that we have, you know, business as normal with regards to the trials we're running. And then hopefully in Q3, we will have successfully completed the move into the new facility.
All understood, Mo. And I imagine you must be feeling pretty fortunate at the moment, because of the way it's all worked out with the timings. It's not really going to be adding any significant cost either, is it?
Yes, that's true, Tom. So a key reason for the timing of the move really is that we are getting a substantial funding from our clients for us to open up the new facilities. So that's a huge bonus for us. But it does mean that we will be able to deliver our clients' trials much faster because we will have more rooms available to run the quarantine beds. And overall, the cost per bed in the new facility is very similar to what we are paying now. So all in all, they're effectively not substantial increases in the fit out and the move or the kind of the day-to-day maintenance and running of the new facility. So over, you know, taking everything into account from an operational point of view, from a financial point of view, from a strategic growth point of view, it's the ideal move for us and the ideal time.
Very best of luck with it all, Mo. Great to see you as always. And hopefully we'll catch you again very soon right here on Proactive.
Thank you for having me on, Tom. Take care.